Hey, this is Barry and Holli of the WQSB Morning Show. Thank you for listening to our podcast, and we want to say a special thank you to our sponsors.
Looking for the ultimate day out? Dive into the excitement at the Gadsden Mall. From latest fashion finds, one-of-a-kind shops, we've got something for everyone. Craving a bite? Indulge in a culinary adventure with a world of dining options right at your fingertips. Don't miss out on top-notch entertainment. Bowling, games, mini-golf, box office films, so much fun for all ages. Experience it all at the Gadsden Mall, where shopping, food, and fun come together. Visit us today at the Gadsden Mall at 1001 Rainbow Drive, Gadsden.
It's time to rise and shine and get your morning started with Alabama's award-winning morning show.
Oh, 600, what's the O stand for? Oh, my God, it's early.
We've got all the happiness we need. Happy, happy, happy.
Broadcasting live from high atop Alabama's beautiful sand mountain.
I'm sorry, but this is crazy. This whole thing is crazy.
I listen to you guys every morning.
I bet your stories will make me laugh so hard I shoot milk out of my nose.
Please welcome your hosts, Barry.
I think I found a job. There was an opening for a janitor at the TV station. Get this, they're going to pay me the minimum wage.
And Holli.
Is it tacky to say I'm rich on an online dating profile?
I don't need to put the word filthy in front of it.
Mr. Blue Sky, please tell us why you had to hide away for so long.
Laugh in the face of danger, then I hide until it goes away.
Good morning, it's 6:10. It is a beautiful morning.
It is a beautiful morning.
Look,
we've got
sky.
An amazing sunrise. Isn't that pretty?
That is beautiful.
It's meant to be.
It is like a Mr. Blue Sky.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's 6:11. It's going to be another warm day, 94. They say cool front coming in. I don't call 94 cooler.
Mm.
What they mean by this is the lower humidity. Starting maybe tomorrow.
I think we're all excited for the 77 that you said yesterday.
Yeah.
That's coming next week.
They're showing by, let me pull up the extended forecast. They're showing by Wednesday highs in the upper 70s.
Oh,
how about that?
I'll take that.
It gets better each day, and we need rain. There's a decent chance of rain each day. Today, just a slight chance. We're heading out to high school football. Get hot today. Slight chance of rain tonight, so you could see rain. Doubtful, but you might. Tomorrow, a little better. 40% chance. 91. Then Sunday, 60% chance, and in the upper 80s. And then beginning on Labor Day, Monday, we should stay in the upper 80s and 80s for all of next week until Wednesday. Then it goes to the upper 70s.
Ooh. I'll take it.
Much better. 68 in Fort Payne, 69 in Gadsden. It's 70 here at QSB. Today's a big day. It's for many reasons, but it's a big celebration today. And we've got some special music we get to play. Are you ready?
Happy anniversary, baby.
I got you on my mind. I love it.
So it is the happy anniversary to you.
Happy anniversary to you, sir.
1 year today you've been on the morning show.
1 whole year of the morning show with Barry and Holli.
We've had so many nice comments on the podcast post from yesterday. People talking about the anniversary and talking about us.
Yep.
And we appreciate that. It's not all about us. We do this for you, the listeners. We just try to give you something to get your mind off of your whatever's going on in the morning. You're on your way to a job you may not like. On your way to school that you don't want to go to, which, and I understand.
Oh, we get it.
We try to give you a little something, and today we're giving you a lot of somethings, a lot of prizes.
Yeah, we have a lot of somethings. We have some baskets to give away, free pizza, gift certificates from Papa Doobie's. We have Albertville Discount Tire. We have 5 Brandon Brock's. We have Jamie Johnson tickets.
Concert tickets for tomorrow night's show.
Yes.
It's tomorrow night, right?
It's tomorrow night, yeah.
Yeah.
We do. We have got a set of those, and we've got more, even more prizes.
Yeah, and we have brought our special Will into the room.
Yes.
Not Will Brumbelow, he is special.
No, he's
good. Coming later this morning.
Yeah.
But the actual wheel that you spin. Why don't you reach over and give it a quick spin, ready?
All right, hold on. That good?
It's pretty good. Okay. And here's the deal. We're going to be changing prices on it all during the show.
Yep.
And each time you spin, there will be 3 things it can land on. 3.
Yes.
You'll have 2 good ones and then 1 that's not so good.
Yes.
Which, if it's called the Wheel of Waddles. We're saluting our favorite Goose friend who unfortunately passed away during the early in the summer.
So sad.
Yeah.
Well, we are doing in memory of, and also it is in memory of Reid. Today's mm-hmm. episode is dedicated to Barry's son, Reid.
It is.
Who passed away 3 years ago today.
Yeah.
This is the first time that Barry has been back or been working on this day since Reid has passed. And we're all so proud of him because it's not that we're moving on from Reid's memory, but we're moving on in honor of Reid.
Yeah, I know some people say, well, wow, it's been 3 years, shouldn't he be over it? Because I honestly had somebody to say that to me about a year ago.
That's horrible.
And I just looked at him, because this is a person I thought was a friend, and I just looked at him and thought, man, you've never lost someone close to you, because grief doesn't have a timeline.
No.
You never know.
Yeah.
You don't know.
And especially with a child. I mean, yeah. To lose a child, that's, I think, as hard as you could possibly go.
And I will say this, that since you've come in, you've brought a lot of new listeners because you had a career before this with YouTube online, and you had a lot of followers who began listening to us, and they may not be familiar with a lot of our, or at least my backstory.
Mm-hmm.
They follow you. They know your story, a lot of it. So if you're new to QSB and you're not really familiar with what we're talking about, around 8:30, and we're going to play something.
Yeah.
And it's something that when I came back 3 years ago, I took 2 weeks off when my son passed. And when I did come back, I talked about it for the first time. Nobody really knew a lot about it because I'm just not a public person. And that's mm-hmm. not something you just go around telling the world the details. We recorded what I said on the morning show that morning.
Mm-hmm.
It was, and if you missed it, we're going to play it again.
Yeah.
The recording of what happened that morning.
Yeah.
On the morning show 3 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So that's coming up around 8:30.
Yeah. So it's a bittersweet day.
It's
going to be our 100th podcast. So
right?
Happy 100th podcast.
Isn't that crazy how it falls on this our anniversary day?
That's what my mom was saying. I was talking to her about Reid yesterday and about you. And I was like, Mom, what can I do? What can I say? And I've written a letter to Reid,
mm-hmm.
and I'm going to read that about 8:30 when we play. I would like to read that to you. And I told her that I feel so helpless. There's literally like nothing I can do or say that's right or takes it away. Nothing takes the pain away, but she said you can move forward. And so that's what we're choosing to do, is to just make the best of this day the best way that we know how. And if you would like to leave Barry a message of prayers, he's made a post on our Facebook page, and he reads, he may not be able to get to respond, but right. He is reading every single comment that comes in on our Facebook page.
And this is crazy.
And we're so thankful.
Thank you so much for the listeners. That's why I'm back.
Yeah.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah.
I do this to try to encourage somebody. If there's somebody out there who's going through something similar, then maybe there's something I can say. I don't know what it might be, but it might give you some encouragement.
Yeah.
Maybe just being here, showing that, yeah, life does stink.
Mm-hmm.
Bad, but sometimes you just got to, you know, try your best to move forward and mm-hmm. try to help yourself and help others.
Yeah.
So, but thank you. I'm looking at Facebook now popping up, and 318 people have responded. I haven't refreshed it in a few minutes.
It's over 400.
Wow. And this has just been a little over an hour. That is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
And at least 110 comments I'm seeing. I haven't had a chance to read all of them, but these those who are saying a prayer today, thank you. Thank you
yeah.
very much, because I'm convinced prayer is the only reason I'm here.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it does help.
Not
everything that it doesn't help. It
yeah.
does. It does.
Yeah.
So anyway, we're going to be talking about stuff off and on this morning. And unfortunately, Holli does have a whistle.
I do. Can I do a practice whistle?
Yes.
Because I really am curious how it's going to sound on the air.
Okay.
Oh, that's not bad.
That's not bad. So whenever you hear the whistle on
the
air.
That was at like 50%. I didn't go 100%.
Oh, please don't.
Okay, I'll just go 50.
So whenever you hear this, that means you need to be the first caller through.
Yep, 878-8000.
1-800-233-1051. And the very first caller that calls in, you're going to get to spin the wheel. Well, you don't actually get to come in the room.
We're just going to spin it for you.
We'll spin it for you. Yeah. And you have a chance to win a prize. So go ahead and call now. We're not just practicing.
Yeah,
this is not.
Hold on.
Here again. You know, Russ and Dave next door hate you right now.
They love me.
Yeah, because
I've already went in and had a meeting with them and said, guys, I have a whistle. Hey, Let's answer.
All right, we'll do it. We'll come, we'll play the commercials and take our caller.
All right.
We'll spin the wheel on the air. All right, 618.
Mornings with Barry and Holli here on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Now, a lot of things going on. We're kind of running behind this morning since we have so much stuff going on.
How'd you know?
Well, I just know because I'm looking at the clock. And we usually do things you need to know to kick off the show, so now we're a few minutes behind. So what do we need to know today?
On this date in 30 B.C., Egyptian Queen Cleopatra died. Do you know how she died?
I'd heard this. Is it from the snake thing?
Yeah.
The snake?
It's from a snake called an asp. A-S-P.
Yeah, A-S-P.
Uh-huh. It's like an Egyptian viper or cobra.
Very poisonous. What I looked
up. Yeah, very venomous.
Gotcha.
I think you can call that the first ever asp whooping.
First ass whooping. I guess it was. Yeah.
Whooping.
Poor Cleopatra.
Yep. And
yeah.
I'm so excited to see this morning. Freeform is already announcing their 31 Nights of Halloween. I love this.
I do too.
I love it so much.
I love scary movies.
It's 31 back-to-back nights of frights that will start October 1st. And then it features movies like Casper, Halloween Town, Edward Scissorhands, A Nightmare Before Christmas, Frank and Weenie. Have you ever seen that?
I don't know that one.
Cute.
What is that one? Okay.
It's for kids. It's cute.
Gotcha.
Beetlejuice.
Love Beetlejuice.
I love Beetlejuice. I can't wait for the new one.
Is it this next weekend, I think?
I think it's next weekend.
Yes.
I can't wait. Hocus Pocus 2 and 2023's Haunted Mansion.
Well, those are good movies. A lot of them are good kids' movies, too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And here's something to think about.
Yeah.
Astronomers say that they found a planet very similar to Earth 20 light years away.
Whoa. So it's similar to us?
That's what they say.
Well, how do they know?
I don't know. They say it could be the new Earth, though.
Whoa.
And it's so similar in many ways.
Yeah.
Like, for example, I read that they recently discovered, I think it was 13 Starbucks and 4 Targets.
On this new Earth.
And $18 Generals.
Wow. So as usual, more Dollar Generals than
more
Starbucks.
More Dollar Generals.
I get it, yeah. All right, 627. We have a whole bunch of stuff here to give away this morning.
Well, I got to do these stories, too.
I know. So we got a lot of stuff to get to. And again, I want to say again, thank you to everybody who's commenting and posting and sending in their prayers on our Facebook page. Thank you.
It's an overwhelming amount of people. And I think it truly shows, Barry, how you impact and help people. I don't think you realize that you have such an impact on people's lives, and you help change people's lives and change their days around. And I don't think you are realizing how appreciated you are. And I hope this shows you. This amount of people at 6 o'clock in the morning love you, support Reid, and love WQSB.
It means a lot to me because last 2 years I decided I couldn't work on the day that he passed away.
Mm-hmm.
He passed away at 3:39 in the morning. I know that for a fact. We can get it in more details. I have never really given a whole lot of details about because I feel like almost I'll be disrespecting him in a way.
You're private.
Yeah.
It's okay.
But he passed. Accidental drug overdose. It happened. And he passed when I was getting ready to go to work.
Mm-hmm. And you had a clock. Had a clock that stopped at the time he died.
I mean, it's the craziest thing I've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
And because I know exactly when it happened, and the clock in the room, somehow, no, people may think this is, there's no way, but it did.
It did.
And it stopped at 3:39.
Mm-hmm.
On its own.
On the minute he died. It's wild.
Mm.
It's just the craziest thing.
But thank you again. We'll talk more about this. And coming up around 8:30, going to play something that was my first chance to come back on the air. I took 2 weeks off,
mm-hmm.
and still wasn't ready to come back, but I did. And my first comments on what happened, I kind of explained some details. So we're going to play that again, the recording of me being on the morning show that morning. So I thought it will be hard for me to say it again and go through it again.
Yeah.
I don't think I could, because it's hard to even talk about it.
You don't have to. We'll just listen to the recording that you did 3 years ago.
So we'll do that coming up around 8:30 this morning. But again, thank you so much. Looking at Facebook, that means so much to me. And I'll try to do my best to respond to people, but it means a lot seeing the comments this morning. Thank you very much. And since you've been gone, I know running a few minutes behind, but a lot of things happening in the news, and we try our best not to be, never going to be political. We don't,
no, don't want to, we don't touch don't, that don't with a 10-foot
stir
pole.
That pot.
No.
Yeah, or controversial.
Keep
but
that
there's,
pot over there.
Yeah, but there's some things you may have missed that you might care about. Like, I was curious when Richard Simmons passed away a few weeks ago, like, what happened? And now I think we have details.
Okay, listen. The official report from the Los Angeles Medical Examiner has said that Richard Simmons' death at age 76 was an accident. This is crazy.
Yeah.
It says that his cause of death was blunt traumatic injuries resulting from a ground level fall with cardiovascular disease listed as a contributing condition.
Oh, wow.
So it's been mentioned before that Simmons had experienced an episode of dizziness and collapsed. So I don't know if his heart just gave out this time, or it says blunt traumatic injuries.
He
may hit his head.
Collapse and then hit his head.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's crazy. It's wild, isn't it?
Hate that.
That's so sad.
Yeah.
And the CIA revealed new details on the terror plot that led to the cancellation of all three of Taylor Swift's era tours in Vienna, Austria.
This is very scary.
Yes.
What could have happened?
It sure is. The planned terror attack intended to kill and injure hundreds of thousands, tens of thousands, tens of thousands of people. And three suspects have been arrested in the case. That's crazy.
So they were going to bring in bombs and guns,
yes,
people at the concert.
To kill tens
and kill
of
as
thousands.
Many, that yes. is so horrible.
And probably themselves, too.
That's so horrible to think people are that evil.
Yeah. And they do this because they know that many people are gathered at that
in one
specific
location.
Yeah, in one location.
That is very scary.
Well, thankfully that it was caught. 77% of Americans are too tired to cook after work.
Yes.
A study of 2,000 adults found. I am also too tired to cook after work,
probably,
even lunch.
Probably closer to 97% of are too tired to cook after work.
It says, in fact, about one-fifth have fallen asleep while making food.
No.
Yeah, have you ever done that?
No, that's
scary. I
have
never done that.
So you fall over and your face falls into the peanut butter and bread.
Yep.
That's sad.
51% say that they're busiest during the weekends. And when participants are short on time, they turn to sandwiches,
mm-hmm,
fast food, and microwave dinners.
Yes, we do.
Yeah.
I'm doing all three. Oh, is it time again?
It's
oh, my
time.
Goodness. So what does that mean exactly?
That
for those who don't know what we're doing.
Caller one.
Yeah.
You are going to get a winning prize. We're going to spin the wheel of Waddles.
Yeah, so what you do is you're going to get to spin the wheel.
Yep.
And there's what prizes are on there. There's three slots on the prize wheel.
Yes.
And the three slots each have, there's some cool prizes on there. Like, what do we have on there?
We've got a main channel bucket that has a hat, a cup, and a koozie.
Mm-hmm.
We have Alabama Pizza Co. free pizza, or a $25 gift certificate to Papa Doobie's.
Okay. So, caller number one, you get to play the game. Caller one, 878-8000 or 1-800-233-1051.
Barry and Holli on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Simpson's on the phone. Hey, Melissa, how are you doing?
Good morning.
Melissa.
I'm doing great.
She's one of our favorite listeners.
Yeah.
She's been listening for a long time, haven't you, Melissa?
I have.
I think it's only fitting that you get to spin the wheel of Waddles. And now, what do we have on the wheel this time, Holli?
So on the wheel this time, we have a main channel bucket, a free 16-inch pizza from Alabama Pizza Co.
Yeah.
And a $25 Papa Doobie's gift card.
Melissa, are you ready?
I'm ready.
We're going to spin the wheel.
All right. Spinning.
All right. Slowing down. And what did it stop on?
Free Papa Doobie's gift card.
Yes.
Woo-hoo!
Congratulations, Melissa. I know this is probably the greatest thing that's ever happened to you.
And ever.
Yes, ever. Remember this moment forever.
Ever.
Seriously, we do appreciate you, Melissa. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy. You can have lunch on us one day. How about that?
Perfect. Thank
you. You're welcome.
Thanks, Melissa.
Have a good day. Thanks for listening. And we'll be doing this all day today, so we have more stuff to give away. Get ready for your chance to win 94 The Hot Today. Weather details coming up. Here's Chris Jansen on QSB. This is weird.
Yeah.
Because one of the first movies I took Reid to see was Jurassic Park.
Really?
And now you're telling me that there's... I thought Jurassic Park / World was over, but it's not. They're bringing it back?
No, they're bringing it back. Jurassic World is called Rebirth. is set to release in July 2025. The plot follows Scarlett Johansson leading a team extracting DNA samples.
Well, definitely have to go see that.
With Scarlett Johansson, yes.
And that's surprising. I mean, it's not just like some nobody, but she's one of the producers behind this. Yeah. She is the one bringing it back.
And didn't you watch the show Manifest?
Manifest was good, dealing with the plane that kind of disappeared for I think 5-6 years. It was a pretty good show.
Well, more Manifest may be on the way. There's been rumors that a spinoff might happen.
Oh.
Yeah, the creators of the show say that they're hard at work on a spinoff show, but no other further details have been given.
The only thing I've read is that there's still some unanswered questions on what happened, and they want to answer more questions, and this is their way of doing it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that makes sense. Steph Curry and the Golden State Warriors have extended his contract for the 2026-27 season for guess how much?
No telling.
A sickening amount of money.
No telling.
$63 million.
To play, what, 2-3 more years?
Yeah, but listen to this. By the end of the 2026-27 season, Curry's on-court earnings will reach about $532 million is the second most in NBA history.
So he will have made that much in his career.
Yes.
Unbelievable.
$532 million.
Unbelievable.
That's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
And then Netflix announced its docuseries, Mr. McMahon, based on the rise and fall of WWE founder Vince McMahon.
Ah.
It's going to premiere September 25th. I think that'll be interesting.
That'll be fun to watch because he pretty much brought wrestling back.
Yeah.
And made it popular again.
Yeah.
Have to watch that. Yeah, it's 6:52. Birthdays are next.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holli.
A good one to listen to because a lot of stuff going on today.
Yeah.
Including today. Today's a hard day. It's August 30th. And mm-hmm. It's 3 years ago today. My son passed away as I was getting ready to leave for work. It was tough. It was the hardest day of my life.
Mm-hmm.
Hardest day of my life. And we're going to play something at 8:30 because it's still hard to even talk about.
Mm-hmm.
It's very hard to even discuss. And this because any time I start talking, I usually can't finish.
That's okay.
And it's hard. Even though it's been 3 years, grief doesn't have a time frame. You hurt, and it's hard to get past. Everybody's different.
No.
But we're going to play something at 8:30 that the day after I came back on the morning show, or 2 weeks after it happened, I took 2 weeks off. And the first time I was on the air, I gave details, and this went over some of the things that happened and why I was gone. And we recorded that. I'm going to play that recording from 3 years ago, coming up around 8:30.
Yeah, and if you're out of the car and don't have time to listen to it, I'm going to leave it on the podcast so you can listen to it there. And I think this is really heavy on my heart, so I have to say this.
Okay.
Healing is linear. Healing is not trending upwards. Healing is dropping down some days. And some days you're not at your best, Barry. And you come in here every day with a smile on your face and you check it at the door. I don't know how you do it. I strongly admire you. Because I cannot imagine ever, ever going through the terror that you've gone through in the last 3 years. People don't know that you live that moment every day of your life when you found him.
Yeah.
And healing is not linear to those out there listening. If you're listening to us and you're going through something, it does get better and it may get worse sometimes, but just hold on to hope. And then I'll go ahead with the quote of the day, if that's okay.
Yeah, like you were saying, today's hard. The last 2 years on this particular day, I took the day off because I just didn't think I could go in and be my best on the radio. And today, it's tough. It's a struggle.
It's almost like you feel fake because you don't want to be too happy because it's a tragic day, but you can't be too sad because we can't bring the listeners down. We've got to bring them the best of us. And so it's not that we checked Reid at the door. We're carrying Reid with us today.
And something I'm doing today, I have his picture on the board.
Yeah.
So anyway, coming up at 8:30, we'll do that. And you've got something you also wrote that you're going to read, and I haven't heard it yet, so I appreciate that. I'm looking forward to hearing that. But, yeah, the quote of the day kind of ties in with this. And then anybody who's lost a child, I'm praying for you because it's the hardest thing I've ever gone through.
And, you know, a lot of it's more often than I realize when you talk about Reid, somebody always comes back with I lost my child.
Yes.
And it just has amazed me, the small community of people that have lost children. And it is horrible.
It's the worst thing that can happen to a parent. It is. And the quote of the day kind of ties into that.
Yeah. I heard you say this one time. You said it's a club that nobody wants to be a part of.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The quote is, the longest walk home that any parent will ever take is the one after their child has run ahead of them.
That's so true.
Yeah.
Yeah. And to end this little break on a happier note, I want this to be more like a tribute and honoring a Reid. And there was one of the moments that was one of the funniest ones that ever happened to us.
Yeah.
The day he got his license, his driver's license, I took him to Gunnersville. And he got his driver's license. He went back and he had to do the driving test and the whole works and came out. And he was so excited. And he came out and I sat in the lobby and he said, "Hey, Dad." I said, "Yeah." He said, "Guess what?" I said, "What?" He said, "I'm going to be an organ donor."
Oh.
I said, "That is awesome."
Yeah.
Because I, too, am an organ donor. He said, "Really?" He said, "Yeah." He said, "I thought about it when that woman asked me, do you want to be an organ donor?" And I thought, yeah. Because actually, me and Reagan, his sister, my daughter, we have this keyboard thing that she bought us for a few years ago, and Reagan doesn't use it much anymore, so I'm going to give it to him.
No, like that's the organ? Oh, no.
I'm being serious.
Wrong organs, Reid. Wrong organ.
So I laughed and said, "No, wait a minute." I said, "That is funny." He said, "Why are you laughing?" I said, "That's not the organs we're talking about. They mean your heart and your lungs."
Yeah.
He said, "No way."
What did he say? What was his reaction?
I said, "Are you serious?" I said, "Yeah, I'm being serious." He said, "Oh."
Yeah.
I got that totally wrong on that one. He said, "But I still want to do it."
Yeah, he still continued to be an organ donor, even though he didn't have to give up Reagan's organ. But
that's one of the funniest moments.
he was willing to tribute.
Yeah, he's going to give Reagan's keyboard away because it was an organ donor.
That's a good memory.
Yeah, that was good.
Guess what?
Oh, no, is it whistle time? Oh, my goodness. Yep, it is time. She's blowing the whistle. So the first caller through on either contest line, you get to spin the wheel of Waddles. Now, what can they win on this particular spin?
There's
three slots on the wheel. What's on the slots?
Yep, and they are ever
looking for the ultimate day out. Dive into the excitement at the Gadsden Mall. From latest fashion finds, one-of-a-kind shops, we've got something for everyone. Craving a bite? Indulge in a culinary adventure with a world of dining options right at your fingertips. Don't miss out on top-notch entertainment. Bowling, games, mini golf, box office films, so much fun for all ages. Experience it all at the Gadsden Mall, where shopping, food, and fun come together. Visit us today at the Gadsden Mall at 1001 Rainbow Drive, Gadsden. Baby, got you on
my WQSB, it's anniversary day, the one-year anniversary of the morning show, and Tanya Haney, another one of our favorite listeners, is on the phone. Hey, Tanya, how are you?
Good morning. Good, thank you.
You ready to win something very nice? I've got a good feeling. What do you think, Holli?
I got a good feeling.
Yeah, so, Tanya, on the wheel this time, we have three slots on the wheel. What's on there again, Holli?
All right, we have a main channel bucket with a hat, we have two Jamie Johnson tickets, and we have 50 cents worth of gas.
All right. Are you ready, Tanya?
I'm ready.
We're going to spin the wheel.
That's a good spin.
Looks like she wins 50.
It's 50 cents worth of gas.
Hold on, we're about to give it to you. There you are, Tanya. Congratulations. Nope. Okay, that's not nice.
Let's spin it again.
That's
spin
not
it
nice.
Again.
We're going to spin it one more
spin
time.
One more time.
That was rude. That was Holli that did that, by the way.
Not me.
Yeah. But Tanya, this time it's landed on something better, I think.
You got two tickets to see Jamie Johnson.
Yes. Congratulations for your way
good.
To go.
All right.
Well, Tanya, that's tomorrow night at the Sand Mountain Amphitheater in Albertville, and you're going for free. How about that?
That sounds great.
Well, thank you so much for listening to QSB. We appreciate you, and we'll see you soon, okay? QSB George Jones, it is finally Friday, 7:37, Barry and Holli. One-year anniversary of the morning show, and appreciate all the nice comments. And thank you so much for the nice comments on our Facebook page. Posted something earlier. It's a weird day. It's a sad day, happy day, all mixed in one. It's weird how it turned out that today is the 100th podcast episode of our podcast that's is going to be going up to listen to around 9:30 or so. Mm-hmm. And it just happened to fall on the same day that's the 1 year anniversary of the morning show, and also the 3 year anniversary of the day my son passed.
Yeah.
It's odd how all these get combined.
It's meant to be. This has got to be a God thing, because I launched the podcast with no specific date and time.
No.
I had nothing planned out for the future. I really didn't know if we would get past 10 podcasts.
Sure.
I didn't know how it would do. But we have hit, this is our 100th episode, mm-hmm. and it's on Reid's anniversary, yeah, so it's just meant to be.
Yeah, we're honored that people listen to the podcast. It means a lot, what the podcast is. Sometimes people hear a podcast, they think, oh, it's some kind of a news information type, boring type thing, which, I hope it's not boring, but it's just that the morning show and what we do for 3 hours, then you go through and you take out, because legally we have to take out the music.
Yeah.
And we don't have the rights to that, and we take out the commercials, and then it's just the talk. And a lot of times it deals with the listeners' names. We have listeners' voices on there. Like today we're doing a lot of contests. So if you win something, you can go back and listen to the podcast and hear yourself on the radio.
Yeah, you sure can.
Yeah. And so anyway, that's what the podcast is. This is us trying to have fun. It's about roughly anywhere from 45 minutes to an hour.
Yeah.
And so if you're listening on the way into something and you miss something, you can go back anytime ever and go back and listen to it.
Or if you just miss us.
Yeah.
And be like, man, I wish I had Barry and Holli on right now. You can at any time, 24/7.
I don't see that happening, but you're welcome to.
I mean, if you could, if you wanted to.
But you can find the podcast anywhere you find podcasts. This one, Apple, there's many ways to find it.
Spotify.
Our website.
Tune in.
But we encourage you to go to our Facebook page, because that's where you can listen and you can comment. And when you make a comment, Monday we're going to take all the comments from this weekend, from today.
Mm-hmm.
And then have a drawing. And what do we know what they're going to win Monday?
No, I have no idea. But it'll be a prize worth listening for. Yeah. So it's actually a surprise what I'm going to be giving away. Okay. It's a surprise.
It could be anything from tickets to food, t-shirts, all kinds of stuff.
Yep, all kinds.
But anyway, thank you for the podcast and listening to it. And by the way, if you'd like to be a podcast sponsor, which right now, thank you to the Gadsden Mall. They're sponsoring our podcast right now.
Yeah, and we're so thankful to have September podcast sponsors. So if you would like to sponsor the month of October or later, you want to schedule out, just give me an email at Holli, H-O-L-L-I, at WQSV.com.
Yeah. And again, today is an unusual day. It's a very hard day. Doing my best to be on the show.
Mm-hmm.
And I think, we're going to play something at 8:30. So if you missed it, if you're new to the station, not been around much, and around 8:30 we're going to play something. It's what was my first day back after Reid passed. I took 2 weeks off. Then I spoke on the morning show that morning, and it's the recording of what I said that day. Mm-hmm. I don't like to get into details because it's hard to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
But we have the recording, and we'll play that coming up around 8:30. And you also have something special that you've written that I'm looking forward to hearing.
Yeah, I've written Reid a letter. And I'm going to read that to you around 8:30.
Yeah, all right. So, happier news. Keep listening. Coming up in a few minutes. Keep listening for the whistle. Not yet. You'll have a chance to spin our wheel as we celebrate the anniversary. That's coming up in a few minutes here on QSB.
WQSB. Mornings with Barry and Holli.
QSB, it's Chris Young.
Happy anniversary,
our one-year anniversary today. And we've got all kinds of stuff we're giving away. And on the phone with us, our links player is April Hanrahan from Boaz. April, good morning, and how are you doing today? Thank you so much for listening to us, April. We appreciate that. And we're going to try to give you something nice. Now, on the prize wheel this time, what do we have on there again? Do we have something new?
Yep, we've got Albertville Discount Tire. We have fare tickets. And we have a free quack from Waddles.
Oh, my goodness. Well, April, any of those you like to win? Is there anything that piques your interest?
Yeah, the fare tickets.
The fare tickets. Okay, well, let's see what we can do for you. Here we go. We're going to spin the wheel.
Spin that wheel.
And it's landing on
a free quack from Waddles.
Oh, that's Waddles right there. Yeah, but I tell you what, you can't take Waddles the quack with you, because Waddles is now in the
heaven. But you can go to the fair.
Why don't we spin it again?
Let's do it.
One more time, just for April.
Hold on. It's either Albertville Discount Tire or fair tickets.
Here we go. This time it's stopping on fair tickets.
Yay!
Yes! April, you're going to the Marshall County Fair in a couple of weeks. How about that?
Thank you. I appreciate it so much.
You are welcome, and you can feel free to use the Waddles quack any way you'd like to. Feel free. All right. Thanks, April. Have a great day.
You too.
All right, and we have more coming up next hour, and it's time out. It's Friday. QSB, Cody Johnson and Dirt Cheap. It's 8:06 with Barry and Holli and a whole room full of folks. I think you got the times wrong, guys. We're supposed to meet like at 4 o'clock today, and here we are at 8, and you're already up here. John Gladden, Chris Jenkins, and Keith Ball, the Power 107.5 High School Football Albertville crew. And got a big game tonight. But you guys come in early. You surprised me. I thought, man, they got their clocks all wrong.
Well, I was looking for a reason not to have to go to the chicken farm this morning. So
anything to get out of work.
Yeah, we wanted to come come see you this morning. No, it's a sad day for you and an important day, and we wanted to just kind of come and be here with you and be present for a minute and just love on you a little bit.
Well, that means a lot, because I tell you, it happened 3 years ago, and the week after it happened, we had a football game, and we thought about it, and I thought about it, and thought, I don't know if I can actually do this. But I couldn't have done it without y'all three. I couldn't.
No, I remember that day very, very vividly. It was, you asked for us to give you some time, and we were like, brother, take whatever you need. If you need the whole pregame, you take the whole pregame, whatever you need to do. But I do remember, one thing that I remember is that I didn't know what to do. I didn't know how to support you at the time, because I don't think anybody on our crew really knew exactly how to support you. We just wanted to be there for you. But I remember when you got through, the only thing that crossed my mind is, I've been a football player and around football literally since the day I was born. I don't know if you remember this, but when it was all said and done with, I took my hand and I popped you real hard on the butt like we do in football, and I'm like, let's go get them. And that was that's the only way I knew how to support you. So I hope you don't hope you're not still mad at a pop jump while we play football.
No, I think that fired me up. That allowed me to be able to do it. But without y'all that day, I told you probably 2 weeks later that I don't remember a lot about the game. I don't even know who they played that night. I mean, honestly don't.
You just went on into autopilot like you do. That's okay. They're trying to figure it out over there. They're putting their brains together.
Because it was the third game of the season, but I don't remember if it was I don't know if it was an area game, a region game. I don't remember.
It was Florence.
It may have been Florence. So we played them the last couple of years, the third game. And we've said this before, probably remember that game a little better than you do. But once kickoff went, it was, I mean, you were just like you always were. I mean, you were perfect on air. You did a great job. And I know that probably helped you a little bit, just kind of getting that out of your mind and doing football for a little while, a couple hours. And then, you know, obviously you had to go back and deal with that later on that night. But again, you know, just speaking for our team, we love you and you're just a great dude, and you're like Holli said this morning on the air, you're so important to so many people, and you help so many people, whether you know it or not. And so we just kind of wanted to show up and hang out with you for a minute.
Well, that means a lot. I appreciate it. So that means I get free dinner tonight, or what is it?
Sure you do.
Sit to me on the stations on Mrs. Currington's dime tonight, so we'll eat on that. But I got some donuts. Hey, it means a lot, y'all coming by this morning. I appreciate that.
It's our pleasure, Barry. I mean, we kind of, I guess, refer to ourselves and cut up, and we call ourselves the Wolf Pack, but you kind of the lead dog on the Wolf Pack, we don't do anything without you, my man.
No, I've worked with a lot of football games, and you're the best crew I've ever worked with. So I appreciate y'all now. We'll be on the air tonight at 6:30 in Boaz. It's going to be always a big game. Can't wait to call the game tonight.
And now the next biggest decision we have is where we're actually going to eat tonight. That'll be the next round of text messages with our group.
Well, guys, I appreciate y'all, and we'll see you later tonight.
All right,
it's 8:09.
Barry and Holli on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Hey, Lisa, how are you doing?
Hey, I'm good.
We appreciate you listening. I think she's at work. So if you would, Holli, don't blow the whistle again. It'll get her in trouble.
I won't.
But we're going to spin the wheel quietly, Lisa. We'll put a muffler on it so it won't be as loud. And what is on the wheel that she can win?
She can win a $25 gift certificate from Papa Doobie's.
Okay.
Albertville Discount Tire Oil Change.
Yeah.
Or a tub full of crickets.
Ooh.
I'm whispering.
All right, Lisa, are you ready to spin that wheel?
I'm ready.
Here we go. It is spinning, and it looks like she has won. Oh, no.
The tub of crickets.
But don't give up, Lisa. We're not through yet, because we don't want to give you a tub of crickets. We appreciate you. Can we spin
that thing again?
Can we spin it one more time?
One more time.
Okay, one more time just for Lisa. And if you're her boss, just be quiet. She's doing her best to win stuff. What'd you win?
Papa Doobie's gift card.
Yes, there we go.
Woo!
You're going to be having lunch or dinner or whatever at Papa Doobie's in the near future. How about that, Lisa?
Oh, that's great.
Well, you are a winner. I hope we didn't get you in trouble. If we did, we can write you a note to the principal or whatever.
Yeah.
Well, Lisa, seriously, we appreciate you listening. Thank you so much. And I hope you have a great day, okay?
Thank you. You too. Thank you.
All right. You're welcome. Thank you very much. So another happy winner there. Thank you to Lisa for calling in and winning.
Yeah, hey, I've got another winner. We got a winner from last night. Mike was there at the fire plug.
Okay.
And we have a winner. Colin Chase is the winner of Sand Mountain Idol.
Oh, now you say you've heard him sing before.
My goodness, yes. I have to tell you, he's one of my favorite local singers ever of all time.
Gotcha.
He does such a good job.
So I think he's going to be joining us next week here on the morning show.
Yep.
Maybe we can get him to sing here live on the morning show.
I think we could talk him into it.
Yeah. And something coming up in just a few minutes. It's, 8:20, so we're going to play this coming up in a few minutes. And today, we're celebrating our one-year anniversary of the morning show. And also, we're not celebrating, but we're honoring my son, Reid, who passed away 3 years ago this morning. And I haven't worked the last 2 years. I just didn't think I could do it, and today has been extremely hard. Really, I hope I haven't done a horrible job.
You've done
great.
I've
tried my best, but I wanted to do something to honor him, and I've done my best and doing things, and we're going to play something coming up in just a little over 10 minutes. The day I came back, after taking 2 weeks off, after he passed away, one of the breaks when I talked about some of the things that happened, and I told you, I said, I don't know that I can do that again today. Even though it's been 3 years, people, and some people in their minds think, it's been 3 years, you should be okay by now. And
no.
Somebody actually said that to me about a year ago.
That is not what you say to somebody
that's
in grief. Yes.
I don't think that ever lost anyone like that. And that if you have, you'll understand more. It's not something you say to somebody. Everyone takes grief differently. They handle grief differently.
Yes, they do.
And even though it's been 3 years, it's still hard to talk about it just in a casual conversation.
Yeah.
Because like talking to my buddies, I mean, these are my friends a few minutes ago. It was hard to talk to even John, Keith, and Chris.
Yeah.
Even though we're close, it's still hard to talk.
Yeah.
It's hard to talk to you.
I know it is.
Yeah, it is. But we're going to play something coming up, and that's my way of explaining some of the things that happened, what I went through, in the best way I can.
Yeah.
Because we have a lot of new listeners over the past couple of years that people have come in, like since you've been with us for a year, a lot of new listeners. They may not have a clue of what we're talking about, but it'll kind of give you a clue of what we're talking about.
Yeah, and I've written a letter to read, and I would like to read that to you if you're comfortable with it on air right before we play that.
So I tell you, one thing we'll do is, because once we play this, it's going to be just a little more serious, so I think we need to maybe do this one more time. What do you think? Maybe another?
Oh,
what do you think, another
right
one?
Right now, yeah.
Blow that whistle.
Hold on. I blew a short one.
So, okay, so we'll do it again right now. The first caller through, we're going to give you a chance to spin the wheel and win something. So she'll be figuring out what to put on the wheel. But caller number one, call either 878-8000 or 1-800-233-1051.
WQSB, Mornings with Barry and Holli.
Got you on my mind.
And it is the one-year anniversary of the morning show. On the phone with us, we're talking to our latest player, Josh. Josh Phillips. Hey, Josh. Are you doing okay?
Doing good.
Josh, we appreciate you listening. We're going to give you a chance to win some cool stuff. Now, what is on the wheel this time?
We've got Albertville Discount Tire. We have our last Papa Doobie's gift card. And we have 50 cents in gas.
Oh, 50 cents worth of gas.
Yep.
Well, Josh, we're going to spin the wheel. Here we go. It is landing on 50 cents of gas, which is this. There we go.
That's about
50 cents. No, don't be alarmed. We're going to spin it one more time.
Spin it one more time.
But that is just wrong. I don't know who did that. But Josh, now, look at the Papa Doobie's.
Papa Doobie's gift card.
Josh, you'll be having lunch or dinner very soon, courtesy of QSB. Thank you to Papa Doobie's. And Josh, we do appreciate you listening, okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you so much. So another winner. And the prizes, we have a lot of them.
Yeah.
But we didn't get to give away today. We're going to be giving these away with our podcast. And you can listen to the podcast, any of them. Now, like the one you're going to be today's show.
Yeah.
Is, I think, a special show because it's our 100th podcast.
Yes, it's our 100th podcast. It's our one-year anniversary, and it's the day that we lost Reid. So it was all these anniversaries in one.
And you'll be putting this up sometime 9:30, 10 o'clock, and you can listen to it where you find podcasts on our website. Or we recommend going to our Facebook page.
Yes.
Because that's where you can listen and comment. Mm-hmm. And if you comment and tell something to catch your attention, then you'll have a chance to win. We're giving away a bunch of stuff next week for those who listen and comment with our podcast.
Yes.
So anyway, the podcast will be coming up very soon. All right, it's 8:25. Here's Cole Wetzel and Jesse Murph on WQSB. QSB, it's 8:35 with Barry and Holli. And what's coming up next is, so this may sound confusing. Maybe you may not understand what we're about to play. But 3 years ago, this morning at 3:39 a.m., I was getting ready to go to work. And my son passed away in the living room in my arms.
Mm-hmm.
And I knew I'll probably, or the last 2 years I've taken off on this day.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, but, you know, I think I need to go work. I think I need to try to get back to normal as close as possible,
mm-hmm.
which will never be a normal again. Once you've lost a child, and especially in that manner, there's no normal again. It's where your world changes completely.
Yeah.
So when I came back to work two weeks after he had passed, one of the first breaks I did was explaining, giving some details without getting too personal, because I don't like to share personal mm-hmm. things. And this was the break I did on the radio. So you told me that instead of trying to talk about it,
mm-hmm. we can play it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going to sound a little odd, but it was from 3 years ago, and this was the break that happened on the radio. So
let's play it.
So here it is.
It's very unusual for me to take 2 weeks off the air. Now, the only time I've ever taken off 2 weeks in a row was 11 years ago when I had open heart surgery and I was out for 2 weeks. So for me to take that long off does mean something unfortunately is going on. And I hate to say that, yes, something has been going on. Without giving all the details, most of which are very personal, I will say that no, it was not COVID. No, I was not sick. No, I was not on vacation. Unfortunately, 2 weeks ago this morning, around 3:30, my son, Brandon Reid Galloway, passed away. I found Reid as I was getting ready to go to work. It had happened only minutes before I got to Reid. I tried CPR, called 911. The paramedics and police were there with me in just minutes. Unfortunately, everything that was tried, we could not save Reid. I do want to thank all the first responders who were there. They did an amazing job, and without giving a lot of details, Reid had struggles for the past few years, but he tried so hard to win this battle. He fought so very hard. It was awful to watch Reid go through this. I have friends who have family members who have fought the same fight. It's so hard to watch someone battle this. The past 2 weeks have been awful. I don't know of a better word. It's awful. To lose a child is something you cannot describe, and I pray no one listening ever has to go through this. I honestly didn't know if I could ever come back on the radio. Not because I don't love my job, because I do. And that's why I wasn't sure if I could do this. 2 weeks ago, I didn't know if I could ever do that again. I lost my smile. I lost my joy. I lost my son. I do have a beautiful daughter, Reagan, who is so amazing. But unfortunately, Reagan has also now lost her only brother. Her heart is also broken. Over the last 2 weeks, so many wonderful people have reached out to me to offer a helping hand, a shoulder to cry on, and an ear to listen to me vent and just talk. And if I can give everyone listening a piece of advice on what to say or do when someone you know goes through this, my advice would be give them a hug. I'm not a hugging person, but trust me, a hug from a friend at a time like this means more to me than 100 handshakes or pats on the back. Sometimes just a hug and a simple, "Hey man, I'm so sorry. I don't know what you're going through, but I love you, and I'm here for you." That means more than anything at a time like this, or at least it has to me. Don't get me wrong. Your text, emails, and comments mean a lot to me. It touches my heart to know that so many people are reaching out and want to talk if I need to talk. Thank you. I did read a piece this morning that says, when you lose a parent, you lose your past. When you lose a spouse, you lose your present, and when you lose a child, you lose your future. That is so true. Reid was so talented. He was so smart, so funny, so musically gifted with a guitar and piano. He lost his future. I talked to my friend, Pastor Matt Brooks, about this a few days ago. Satan battled with Reid for years, making his life extremely tough to be happy. Now, Satan may have won that battle, but I'm here today and proud to say that my son, Reid Galloway, won the war. He gave his life to God and was saved years ago at First Baptist Church in Albertville. And the happiness I have this morning is that I also trust Jesus Christ as my Savior. And I will absolutely see Reid again one day in heaven. No advice on what to say to family members who are going through something similar with a member of their family, the one thing I will say is never give up. Never give up. I would go back and take some of the hard nights and arguments that me and Reid had over the past few years all over again for just one more day with Reid. My house is very lonely now. I keep waiting for Reid to come out of his bedroom and say those two words that began every one of our conversations. Hey, Dad. It was always, hey, Dad, what's for supper? Hey, Dad, what you doing tonight? So please never give up. The fight is hard, but hopefully it'll be worth it in the end for you and your family. There's a website you can go to for more information, hopefully some help. It's familylifecenter.ws. I'm here, back on the air. I promise the WQSP listeners I will do my very best every day to put a smile on your face. I've never claimed to be good at radio, but I do claim to care about the listeners and my friends, and I love all of you. I read a quote this morning that describes my life and what I'm feeling perfectly right now. It's, from the outside looking in, you can never understand. And from the inside looking out, you can never explain what it feels like to lose a child. I do want to play a song. Yes, we are Alabama's country giant, but I came across a song a few days ago that's possibly the most perfect song to help someone who's going through a loss like I have this morning. It's a contemporary Christian song, but I think on this day, it's okay to change formats for just 4 minutes. I'll finish with saying that today is the first day my son Reid has had a chance to listen to me in a way that he's never listened to me before. Reid, I know you're not here, but today you're in the most perfect spot to listen to me do what I love to do. So if you would, Reid, sit back in heaven and know that I love you, your family loves you, and I miss you. I love you, Reid.
Hey, Jelly Roll and I Am Not Okay, and I've been a fan of Jelly Roll since I began listening to his country music.
Yeah.
I don't know much about his rap music. I've never really got into that, but that's the reason why the story that I have now with my son, knowing the story that he tells and he tries, like that song, it's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
It is perfect as far as people who are struggling, whether you're struggling or you have someone in your family struggling. I probably not a single person in this world can say every day that I'm okay. We say that, but we don't mean that. Most people don't.
No, and I love that Jelly Roll says it's okay. It's yeah. He's not okay, but it's all going to be all right.
Eventually it will be. And that's why I'm a big supporter of his music, because he does so much for people battling addictions, battling mental health, because he's been through that and still going through it. He says, I'm not past any of this. I'm still battling every day.
Oh, yeah.
And that's the same with all of us, I think. So that's why I'm a big supporter of him. I love Jelly Roll and what he stands for.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, appreciate all the comments people are making this morning. It means a lot.
Yeah.
And you've got something that you want to read coming up in just a moment.
I do. I have a letter to read. I also have a poem that was sent to us by Alyssa Turley.
Okay.
It's beautiful. She wrote it this morning just for you, okay, after hearing the show.
Wow.
And I've read it. And I think you will love it. And okay, then I can read my letter to read.
I tell you what, we'll take a quick break and come back with that.
Okay.
It's 8:48.
Mary and Holly on Alabama's country giant, WQSB.
Looking for incredible deals and unmatched customer service? Look no further than Nissan of Gadsden. Right now, drive away with unbeatable savings on our entire lineup of new Nissans.
Our listeners are so amazing.
Yeah.
They really are. And anytime, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, anytime we do anything, whether it's a St. Jude Radiothon or a Life South Blood Drive or Second Chance Shelter, Wolfstock Dog Food Promotion,
they respond and help.
They help others, and they've really helped me a lot today. I'm reading through some of the Facebook posts and comments. Thank you. I'm going to take time when I get out of here in a few minutes before the game tonight to take time to read these, because these mean a lot to me, and it means so much that you took time to write something and just comment and to thank you.
Yeah. It does. It means a lot.
Yeah, it does. It does. It's been a tough day. But we have a quote, that the quote of the day, which we put up, is where this started this morning was. And the quote is, it's for those who may have lost somebody. It goes, the longest walk home that any parent will ever take is the one after their child has run ahead of them.
Mm.
So anyone who's lost a child, I pray for you each day, because it's the struggle. It doesn't get better. You can withstand it, you can function, you can at least move around, and
but your life will never be normal again. It'll never be the same, no matter how bad you want it to be. I come to work and do my best, but it's not the same as it was 3 years ago before this happened.
Yeah.
But it's still, I enjoy my job, love my job, but it's still, it's different.
Mm-hmm.
It's a, some days it's a struggle. Mm-hmm. Today's a big struggle, but I thought I needed to come in today.
Yeah. I'm proud of you for coming in, Barry. I think that hopefully, like you said, and like we prayed this morning, both of us had the same prayer. If we can just help one person,
yeah.
If we could just help one person, then it makes coming into work worth it. So I'm proud of you for that.
So anybody out there who is struggling, we think about you, and we'll be thinking about you daily. And a couple of things before we go. One is the lady who is Alisa Turley.
Mm-hmm. Alisa Turley wrote you a poem this morning.
So what does it say?
She says, "The day you died, I held you and cried. I prayed, God, please no. I'm not ready to let him go. I think of you every day, still trying to figure out my way. Today marks 3 years since you've been gone. On this day, I usually stay at home alone. Today, I decided to get up and honor you like you deserve with talk, songs, and memories and more. I feel you with me, helping me get through this day, giving me strength and the right words to say. Son, I love you with all my heart. One day we will be reunited and no longer apart."
Oh, wow. That's good.
That's good.
That is very special.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. And you told me that you had written a letter to
Reid? I wrote a letter to Reid. It's nothing extravagant, and it's, I feel so helpless because you're in our friendship is so deep, and it's because we talk about these things. We talk about the hard things, and we help each other with advice or just even just a shoulder if we need it. But I wrote this for him.
Okay.
"Dear Reid, my name is Holli, and I've had the honor of working with your dad for the past year. I have to say, I've learned a lot about you. I know that you have a heart of gold, a love for movies, and a strong bond with your dad. You two have been through so much together, including this journey of your loss. There's a few things I can tell you about your dad. I think you would be really proud of him. He's won a ton of awards. He's won People's Choice for Best Radio Personality and even runs a radio station as program director for WQSB. He impacts lives daily in a way that only he can do. And through his heartache, he shows up daily to put a smile on our listeners' faces. But we both know that he would trade it all for one more moment with you. I know God has a strong calling on your life, Reid. And it's not going to be carried out in vain. May your story save others and prevent every parent's worst nightmare, the loss of their child. I've watched Barry shed many tears over the last years, each of them counted by our Lord Jesus that now holds you. I believe God has a special purpose for you that you will make a difference, and we will honor your memory. Your story has the power to touch lives and help others, and I can't wait to meet you one day in heaven and tell you all the pranks your dad's pulled on me in the past year. And P.S., thanks for sending the red birds for your dad. He sees you in them every day."
Wow. That's very sweet. That's special. Thank you for taking the time to do that. That means a lot. It's been a year since you've been in here, and I'm so glad you came. And I appreciate you. Thank you very much. And I thought this song would be fitting to play since we both heard it and said, yeah, this is special. So you're Jackson Dean on WQSB.
Looking for the ultimate day out? Dive into the excitement at the Gadsden Mall. From latest fashion finds, one-of-a-kind shops, we've got something for everyone. Craving a bite? Indulge in a culinary adventure with a world of dining options right at your fingertips. Don't miss out on top-notch entertainment. Bowling, games, mini-golf, box office films, so much fun for all ages. Experience it all at the Gadsden Mall, where shopping, food, and fun come together. Visit us today at the Gadsden Mall at 1001 Rainbow Drive, Gadsden.